Today I'm going to show you how to cut out hair in Photoshop 2015. So if you always find it difficult to cut out hair in Photoshop, then this video is for you. So let's jump right in. Hello you guys, my name is Dennis. Welcome and welcome back to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to learn graphic design and how to make creative designs, start now by subscribing and click on the bell so you get notified when we upload new videos every week. So this is Photoshop 2015 and this is the image we want to cut out the hair. And you see, most designers find it difficult to do this, especially when they have pictures that has this type of hair and you've tried different tools and it won't work. And one thing you should know about Photoshop is that Photoshop has different approach to solving problems. You might go to other channels that teaches Photoshop tutorial and they have other method to do this, but this method basically works with images that has one background, just like this one has one white background, so it can work with any other image that has one background. And I'm going to make another episode of this particular video on how to cut out hair with image that is on a complex background, that is background that is not one. Okay, but for this particular video, it's actually for image with one background. Okay, so let's go straight to the video. The first thing you need to do is to duplicate your background layer, which is this image here. You click and drag to here to duplicate, and you have background copy, so you can name this hair cut out, and that's good. So the next thing you're going to do is to create a solid color layer. So you click on new layer, create new layer, and then you can name this layer solid color review, and that's good. Then you click on your adjustment layer and click on solid color, and you can choose any color here and click on OK. And with that, you bring down this layer under the hair cut out layer, and that looks fine. Okay, bring it under the hair cut out layer like this. Okay, fine, succeeded. So you bring it under the hair cut out layer, and what you want to do with this layer is so you see how perfect your cutout is, and it will review the other side of your cutout, so you see how perfect your cutout is. And the next thing you want to do is to click on the hair cutout layer and you go to your background eraser tool. So you click and hold and you select background eraser tool, and when you do that, you click here to adjust your size. I think this is okay. And your hardness, you leave it at 27, it's okay. And the spacing, 25%, is very okay. And you see other options here. Make sure that you select on sampling once. Okay, now what sampling once does is that it samples a particular layer once and works with that particular background. Okay, but it can't sample any other color apart from the first color you sample, and it works with that particular color. When we start doing this, you're going to understand what this sampling once actually means, and your limits should be discontinuous, okay, and tolerance. Now I'm not going to adjust the tolerance now because we are going to work on that when we start removing the background, and I'm going to explain more about the tolerance there. And make sure that you check on the protect foreground color. Okay, if your foreground color is unchecked, make sure that you click this to protect. And now what this does is that it helps protect a particular part of the image. So let's sample a particular color here, and we are going to set our foreground color and sample this particular color here. Okay, I think this is okay. Now it means that you want to protect this particular color of the hair, so wherever your brush finds this color, it leaves that particular color, and that looks fine. So now let's see what we can do with this. Okay, and you try brushing out the hair like this. Okay, let's do this again. Now about sampling, you first of all click on a white layer, and once you click on the white layer, automatically you tell Photoshop that you want to sample white, that you want to erase white. So you start from the white side and then move into the hair. But you, let me zoom in so you see very well. You see, we still have some white scratches around the hair, which is not perfect. Okay, now this is where tolerance comes in. Okay, press Control Alternate Z if you are using a Mac, Control Option Z, okay, to close this up again. Now we're going to adjust our tolerance because it's not actually giving us what we want. Okay, look at that, we still have some white scratches. Then your tolerance will determine how you want the hair to be cut out. Okay, Control Z, then adjust your tolerance again, maybe leave it at 65, then try it again and you see it beginning to be perfect. Okay, and try it again, Control Z again or Command Z, then do this again, 70. Okay, so I think 70 is very, very perfect with this. You can always increase or decrease your brush size when you click on the square bracket like this. Okay, then you do that, you can see how perfect it is. Then I'm going to brush out. Make sure you start from where you have the white background to sample once, that is, you sample the white background and move into the hair. You do the same. Now you see the red solid color we added is being revealed to show us how perfect our cutout is. Okay, then you sample the white and bring it into the hair again. Continue doing that until you are able to cut out the whole hair. Continue sampling and that looks perfect. You click outside and do that again. Okay, and you just have to be very careful so you don't overdo stuff here. Okay, continue doing that and do that again. Okay, and you do that here and do that here again and here. Now you see this technique is very simple, and especially for those that are starting out to use Photoshop, you really enjoy this technique because it makes your workflow very easy and simple. Okay, you keep on doing that. Now you have to be very careful here. Let me zoom in so you see how it works. Very careful so you won't take off the main details here, and that looks fine. Now I've been able to take out the background around the hair. And the next thing I do at this point, I use either my lasso tool, polygonal lasso tool, or I use my paint tool to take off the other part of the background. Okay, let's see how this works. Just like this, you click on your lasso tool, click and hold and select polygonal lasso tool. Then you select this, you click and make this selection here like this to take off this part of the image. Okay, and join that, right click and click on faders and make sure your faders is that one. But your fader radius depends on the quality of your picture, but for low quality pictures I use one and for high resolution pictures I use three. So I'm going to leave it at one for this tutorial. Okay, delete, and this looks fine. But then Control D to deselect, then you click on your background eraser tool again, and with the same settings you can take off these other scratches here. White, okay, and that makes the selection very fine. And then you do the same here again with your polygonal lasso tool selected. You take off this other side of the background again, okay, and right click faders one and delete. So that is off. Then you do the same here again. Now we have been able to take off the hair, so we're going to make a rough selection here and take this off. Okay, this looks fine. Right click and make your faders. Now at this point you can choose any fader radius you want to use, but just have to delete the background off. Control D to deselect. Now you see how it looks like, it looks very sweet and nice. But then if you zoom in very well, you see that there are some rough brushes around here. So then we are going to use the normal eraser tool, which is this eraser tool. Use your square bracket to reduce the brush size. And you're going to brush around here. You can see all these white scratches around here. And you're going to brush that out to get a perfect cut out. Okay, this looks cool. Just brush that out easily, do that, and you're going to see the before and after of this picture and you really like it. Okay, I think this is perfect, but I think this scratch here is not too perfect, so I'm going to use my background eraser tool again and sample here and take off that scratch. Okay, see how it looks very nice and perfect. Okay, now let's see the before and after of this picture and see how it looks like. I'm going to hide this layer and then I'm going to do this. This is the before and this is the after. Before and after, before and after. So now you can save the transparent background and use it on any background you want to use. I'm going to try something out here by bringing a particular background into this image so we see how it looks like. But then you can add all other adjustments you want to add on this image to have a perfect image with this. But with the little knowledge you have now with Photoshop, you can take off hair background easily and perfectly. Let's try something different. Okay, so I'm able to import this background into Photoshop and you can do the exact same thing. Now you can check out the links in the description to download this image and follow up this tutorial, okay, and that will be nice. Then you adjust this like this and let's sit here. Okay, then you can bring this background, press Control and click on your left square bracket to bring it down. Okay, that looks fine. Now my background might not be fine, okay, but I just selected a random background. It might not look cool and nice, but it's just a random background. Okay, I think I can place this here. Cool. Then my solid color, I'm going to reveal it again, but this time I'm going to change my solid color to this. That's cool. Okay, then I'm going to click on my light bulb background and add layer marks like this, and make sure your background, your foreground color is at black, and you know, black hides, white reveals. Use your regular brush tool and brush out this part of the background. Let me do this so you see how it looks like. See how it looks, brush out this part of the background, and then I'm going to review this again. And I can blur this background a little, filter, blur, and Gaussian blur to blur this background a little, and this looks perfect. So you see the final look of our picture. If you learned something new through this tutorial or you enjoyed this video, leave a like, leave a comment, and don't forget to share this video to as many graphic designers as you can so this video can go viral and you help us grow. Thank you very much for watching this video. I'll see you next time.